Welcome back. You're listening to Houston Real Estate Radio. I'm your host, Shanna Register, and today we are broadcasting from the 12th annual Home and Garden Show out at the Woodlands Marriott, Waterway Marriott. And what a great turnout we've had out here today and yesterday as well. Lots of people coming by, talking about all these great exhibitors that are here selling really neat and innovative products. Lots of things going on. If you've got a real estate question, give us a call, 281-882-8088. We'll be happy to answer your real estate questions right here on the air. 281-882-8088. This segment, I am joined with Randy Lemon. He is, of course, the host of Garden Line, and want to talk to him about some things for sellers, because as we go into fall, temperatures start changing, things start changing, and we still have a lot of sellers who want to sell. So welcome to the program.
Well, first of all, welcome to the KTRH family.
Thank you.
Yeah,
appreciate
since
that.
I knew you moved from our sister station to KTRH,
yep.
Which I'm sure is even rocked your phones even more.
It's been wonderful. Yes, it has
nice
been.
Transition.
Yes,
and
absolutely.
You know I love real estate, so.
That's right. That's right. We were just talking about it. You've done a lot of investing yourself and lots of.
But I leave it in the hands of the experts like you. I like it, but I hate the minutia and the paperwork. So I'm so glad I have advocates like you guys on my side.
Well, I appreciate that. You know, I think that this time of year is hard for sellers because they feel like they've sort of missed the boat if they didn't sell over the summer when things were going so great. But sometimes they need to sell in the fall. And so now they're looking at winter coming on. And, you know, I think that it's hard for them. They've got to figure out what to do about the yard, making that curb appeal as they go into the winter months. So I want to hear your take on that. What do you suggest
to those
sellers?
Great point that when you think about it, getting ready for fall selling, because you know the old theory, you know, they got to buy the house before the inter school.
Uh-huh.
I couldn't disagree with that more from a real estate perspective, but you can get it freshened up. You can improve the curb appeal with some of our basic lawn care. We call it winterizing lawn. It's actually a misnomer because we're not really shutting our lawns down here in the Houston, the Gulf Coast area.
Right.
So we're going to fall fertilize it, fall feed it, and it's kind of a three-step program, and we're probably about 30 days away from really investing that time and energy in the fall feeding. I usually say about September 15th is the jumping off point for that here in the Houston area.
It's where you start turning back the sprinkler.
Well, you can do that, but you give it a fall feeding. It's not like going to green it up like it is in the spring or summertime, but at least it keeps it healthy through the winter so that if you do it the right way, you also, if we don't have a harsh winter, then we can have green grass for a long time, all the way through December for sure, and then until it gets really cold in January and February and it really shuts down, then sometimes it'll get brown. But if it's fall fed properly, it is protected and well preserved to go into January and February without being 100% brown in the Houston.
So around September 15th is when they need to fertilize.
Yeah, and it's a big window. And, you know, I usually say on my radio show, it's never too late to do the right thing. Yeah, it's too late to do your summer fertilization at this point in time because you don't want that.
Already.
Yeah, you don't want to do that kind of summer fertilization in our kind of drought stress that we're enjoying right now and things like that. So, and I'm basically, you can go online anywhere I'm at and just Google search my name, Randy Lemon in fall feeding or Randy Lemon in winterizing lawn. And we give, like, several different product recommendations and never just focus on one because there's a lot of good fall winter fertilizers out there for our lawn.
So that's for the lawn, and that's really important. What about those the bushes and the flowers and things that are in the flower bed? Of course, all the flowers are kind of dead and droopy at this point.
Well, we have fall annuals, fall perennials that do great all the way through the winter.
What are some of the native ones?
Well, Texas natives that you want. I would actually stick more, and not the Texas native perennials, but I would stick more towards the annuals that like the wintertime. If you want color from, let's say, end of October, and really October 1st.
Which sellers do.
End of October, Halloween's always a good time to make that transition from your summer flowers to your winter flowers. And we're talking things like the pentas and the pansies. There's so many marigolds, as even zinnias will handle up until the first frost. And it's a nice transitional time because there's a lot of really unique fall/winter color that'll do great until we get an ice storm or do great until we get a freeze below 25 degrees. And granted, we had a horrible, I called it the ninja freeze March 4th, 2014.
It was bad.
But the lawns didn't suffer all that much from them. They rebounded well. Mm-hmm. They may have browned for a couple weeks, but they rebounded quite well if they're taken care of in the fall. And the same thing with the flowers. They may get a burn on, like with the ice storm, but you can get back there, cut the burn off, and they're going to regrow up until we get hot enough again in the springtime to make that transition to the spring color. So, trying to give one or two names of flowers is an unfair proposition because there's a dozen that work quite well. And I threw out just a couple of great examples.
Do you think when sellers go to Lowe's and Home Depot, are they going to find the flowers that are really going to be hardy enough for their yard?
Not really.
Where should they go?
The independent nurseries and garden centers. The mom and pop type shops here in and around the Houston area. You can find generic fill-in-the-gap plants at the big box stores, but you are not going to find the Texas natives. Those Texas natives are going to be at the independent nurseries and garden centers. I throw out a couple of names like Buchanan's in the Heights. They specialize in Texas native. The Arbor Gate up in the Tomball Woodlands area, they specialize in Texas natives. And not just that, but using herbs as landscape material is a great way to transition during
the
winter months.
What's your favorite herb?
I love rosemary. I like rosemary for cooking purposes, no doubt about that, but I like it for a lot of reasons in the landscape because it can put up with anything. And then you get phased by the ice storm March.
I would be a good owner of that plant,
then. If, there is. If you can kill rosemary, you can probably pretty much kill anything. It's so hardy and worthwhile. And the other good thing, besides the fact that it smells great, it like keeps dogs and cats out of certain areas if they roam the property.
Okay.
Something I've had
to
learn to transition to. I went from a residential and a subdivision to property out in the sticks, and I've had to learn to keep certain animals out of certain beds. And one of the ways to do that was all the different herbs that do great during the wintertime for us.
What keeps deer away?
A lot of these herbs that might have some of the essential oils to them. Lemon balm, a good example, citronella, because they brush up against that, releases the oil, they may not want to get that. There's not a lot that keeps the deer away when they're hungry. We always have lists at nurseries, garden centers. Randy Lemon's made lists before. You can get them from extension offices. Deer-resistant plants, deer-resistant. You know what? The deer get hungry enough, they'll eat the deer-resistant plants, too.
It just depends on how hungry they are.
It's usually about smell that keeps them away. If you can kind of humanize some smells in your area, they won't enter your area. I hate to say it works for me. I do have a lot of things like rosemary and lemon balms and citronella on perimeter. I didn't do that to keep the deer away, but I haven't seen a deer on my property in 2 years.
Wow, and that's pretty good.
Some people say, well, you don't have deer in your area. Well, I do, but they seem to be north of 2920, and I'm not even but a quarter mile south of 2920, and yet they don't seem to cross that. They really don't. Very few do, but they also don't want to get into my landscape because of all the smells.
What about palms? Let's talk about those for a minute, because a lot of people like the Mediterranean look. They like the palms in the yard. I know some of mine from last year did not come back. I mean, I kept the stub there. And
they probably didn't come back in January 2010 and February 2011 either. We had some serious ice, not ice storms, but freezes.
Some of them did come back, though. They started putting off some green, and then a few of them didn't.
So. We got spoiled for about 15-plus years. From about 95, 96-ish, we didn't have any of those kind of freezes that would kill the palm trees. Most palm trees are not technically supposed to be able to handle more than anything below 28, 29 for very many hours. And we've had several events since 2010 where we had 12 hours at 18 degrees. You know,
are we just too far south for them?
We are too far north in terms of the freezes, because, you know, near the water, they handle it better. They don't freeze as much, but we lost a lot of them in January 2010 and February 2011. So it's about the variety. You find, and I'll give you the name of the ultimate palm tree. It is a slower grower, but it looks like a queen palm, but it can handle freezes of any kind. And it's called a mule palm. Not a very sexy name, but it's called a mule palm, and it's a cross, and it works for every landscape out there.
Okay, a mule palm. I'll keep that in mind. I'm going to need some of those in my yard. All right, well, we appreciate you coming on the show with us, Randy Lemon. You can listen to his show, Garden Line. And right now, we are broadcasting from the Woodlands Home Show. Lots of great things going on. I'm going to be speaking at 3:00 today. Come out and join us in the Woodlands. Lots of great vendors out here. And if you've got a real estate question, don't forget to call us 281-882-8088. We'll be back here next week between 11 and noon. Thanks for listening to Houston Real Estate Radio. Thank you.